Hi, this is Kashpunisa Bagewari. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to talk about Amazon S3 storage classes part 1. So we will see what are the types of storage classes and frequently accessed and intelligent tier. So which storage classes comes under this category, we will see, and we will have hands-on demo. In part 2, we will see infrequently accessed and object archiving. So let's start with the part 1. So each object in Amazon S3 has a storage class associated with it. For example, if you list the object in an S3 bucket, the console shows the storage class for all the objects in the list. So you can see in this image, if you are having multiple objects in your S3 bucket, so for each object there is a storage class associated with it. So each object having its own storage class, it can be different from other. So you have for each object, you can see here in your console the storage class associated with it. S3 storage classes allows life cycle management for automatic migration of object for cost saving. So if you want to save some cost, so you can set some life cycle management rule and you can move object from one storage class to another storage class after some time period, and by setting the life cycle management rule, you can save your cost about your storage. All S3 storage classes support SSL encryption of data in transit and data encryption at rest. So you will get the data encryption for all storage classes. S3 also regularly verifies the integrity of your data using checksums and provides auto healing capability. So you will get auto healing capability for all your storage classes. All of these storage classes offer high durability. So you will have high durability for all storage classes. Amazon S3 offers a range of storage classes for the objects that you store. You can choose a class depending on your use case scenario and performance access requirement. So we will see there are different types of storage classes available. So as per your use case and access pattern, you can select any of the storage class. So storage classes are categorized in different types. Suppose if you are having data pattern like you are going to access your data very frequently, in that case you can use frequently accessed storage class. So in frequently accessed tier, there are two types of storage classes, that is S3 standard and RRS. So you can use any of this storage class for your frequently accessed data. If your data is less frequently accessed, in that case you can use infrequently accessed tier. In this tier there are again two type of storage classes. One is S3 standard IA and S3 101 IA. So you can choose among these for your infrequently accessed data. Suppose you are unsure and your access pattern is unpredictable. So in that case you can select intelligent tier. So S3 intelligent tier is intelligent enough, so it can select best storage class for your data, for your objects. So if for archiving purpose, there are again two type of storage classes. That is S3 Glacier and S3 Deep Archive. So as per your use case, as per your requirement and as per your access pattern, you can select among this your storage class. So now we are going to see first type, that is first tier, that is frequently accessed object. In frequently accessed, we already see there are two types of storage classes, that is S3 standard and RRS. So for performance sensitive use case, those that require millisecond access and frequently accessed data, Amazon S3 provides the following storage classes, that is S3 standard. This is the default storage class. If you don't specify the storage class, When you upload an object, Amazon S3 assign the S3 standard storage class. So if you are having data, you are going to very frequently access, and you want to retrieve that data in millisecond. In that case, you can use this S3 standard, and this is the default one. So if you not specify any storage class while uploading your object, S3 assign S3 standard. So second is reduce redundancy, nothing but the RRS. The RRS storage class is designed for non-critical reproducible data that can be stored with less redundancy than the S3 standard storage class. So you will have less redundancy, and it can be used for non-critical or reproducible data. So there is a note, AWS recommend that you not use RRS storage class. The S3 standard storage class is more cost effective. So S3 recommends that you do not use this RRS type. Instead of, you can use S3 standard. You will have most, it is most cost effective and better performance, and your object will get stored in multiple AZ. You will get more redundancy here and less charges. So moving in the next part, a storage class for automatically optimizing frequently and infrequently accessed object. So this is our second tier. It is nothing but S3 intelligent tier. So S3 intelligent tier, this storage class is designed to optimize storage costs by automatically moving data to the most cost effective storage access tier without performance impact or operational overhead. So if you want to cost optimized solution, you can use this. If your access pattern is unpredictable or you are unsure about your access pattern, you can use S3 intelligent tier. The intelligent tier storage class is ideal if you want to optimize storage costs automatically for long-lived data when access pattern are unknown or unpredictable. So it is automatically S3 automatically moves your object from one storage class to another as per your access pattern. For a small monthly monitoring and automation fees per object, Amazon S3 monitors access pattern of the object in the S3 intelligent tiering storage class and moves object that have not been accessed for 30 consecutive days to the infrequent access tier. So suppose if you are not accessing object for 30 consecutive days, so S3 intelligent tier moves that object from frequently access to infrequently accessed tier. So you will get that cost saving. And suppose in case if you access that object, then it get again moved back to frequently accessed tier. So you will have most cost saving, and there is you have to pay some small amount for monitoring and automation purpose. There are no retrieval fees when using the S3 intelligent tiering storage class. If an object in the infrequent access tier is accessed, it is automatically moved back to the frequently accessed tier. No additional tiering fees apply when objects are moved between access tiers within the S3 intelligent tiering storage class. So there is no retrieval fees and no movement fees, but you have to pay only some small amount for monitoring and automation. So you will have more cost benefit and for your unpredictable access pattern, you can use this type of storage class. So we have some hands-on demo for storage class. So I log into my AWS account and I'm on my S3 management console. So you can see in my S3 bucket, I'm having two objects, and here we can see in object list, we can see storage class. For all these two objects, I'm having S3 standard, that is the default one. So file is uploading object, if you not specify any storage class, S3 default assigns this standard storage class. So if you want to change storage class, you can go ahead and you can change storage class as any time you select that object. In properties, you can see a storage class. Now it is standard. If I click here, so you can see all the options available here. So you can go ahead, and if you want to select another storage class, so you can now it is my standard one. If I select another, suppose I want to select standard IA, you can read all the details here, and as per your requirement you can select any storage class, and you can move it from one storage class to another at any time. So okay, change. So now you can see, now my storage class is get changed. Now it is a standard one, standard IA. So you can go ahead and you can go property, and you can change your storage class at any time for cost optimization purpose, for your access pattern, as per your access pattern. Okay, I hope you understand this lecture. Okay, we will see you in the second part. Till then, thank you so much. See, stay safe, stay updated, keep watching. Thank you.